far as getting back in the ring, but we are sure that Chris Jericho is the Cruiserweight champ, and it's just a first-class jerk.
Well, I tell you, Jericho may be feeling his oats, but beware you do not get run over by the hungry horse.
The fan gives him a sign, and he has the gall to tear the sign up.
A horse eats the oats.
A horse eats the oats.
The professor should have known that.
It's a little confusing, Larry, but I'm taking notes.
I'm sure you are.
When you get educated, let me know.
No tripod this week, huh?
Welcome to Monday Night Jericho!
Once again, I would like to dedicate my performance tonight to this man right here, Dean Malenko. And you know what? Dean said a lot of things to me during his short, unsuccessful tenure at WCW. But one of the things in particular that struck me, brought tears to my eyes. Speaking of tears to my eyes right now, it took me a long time to find this video clip, Dean. And I would like to show all the people at home what you said. So show it up. Let's see the video.
Be a year now that my father passed away. My father has always been there for me all through the years of my career. And he's still there. He's still there in my heart and my mind. Every time I do walk in the ring, that my last name is Malenko. And the one thing I always think about before I step in that ring, before that bell rings, is that I'm a great Malenko son. I've dedicated the rest of my wrestling career to him.
You know what? When I think of how you dedicated to your career, to your late father, one thing pops in my head. Your father must be rolling in his grave. You're a disgrace to your family, Malenko. You're a failure. You could never wrestle. Your brother sure can't wrestle, and your father certainly can't wrestle. And you call your mediocre career a tribute? You call it a dedication? I call it an immense joke. The only reason you got the Man of a Thousand Holes gimmick is the WCW office gave it to you because you're so darn boring. None of these people care about you. Nobody here wants to see you wrestle, Dean. You're better off sitting at home than being in this ring putting people to sleep. Now, speaking of putting people to sleep, I too have someone I'm dedicating my career to. He's a man who knows one more hold than you do, Dean. He knows one hold. He's a much better ring technician than you. That's not saying much. And he's a lot more exciting than you, which also isn't saying much. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to introduce to you, Mr. Boris Malenko, coming down the aisle. Let's hear it for Boris. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Boris. Let's have a big round of applause for the Boar Man himself, Mr. Boris Malenko.
I think Jericho's getting a little too much on the side of tradition here.
He's been putting time in the gym, you can tell that. He's a little bit bigger than Dean Malenko. Much better looking, I can tell. He's got a heck of a lot more charisma as well. You can tell he's serious. Look at him, ladies and gents. This is the real man of one hold, Mr. Boris Malenko.
This is so degrading and so sad. And
it's disgusting.
I don't even really want to call this thing.
Jericho is a disgrace to the WCW World's Cruiserweight title that was around the waist of Dean Malenko on no less than three occasions.
I'd say if Boris Malenko was alive, he'd be tying Jericho in knots.
The great Malenko, Professor Boris Malenko, was a fine wrestler, a great manager, a great trainer of wrestlers before his untimely death, and now this young man comes in as Jericho calls him Boar Us.
You better be careful. You know, history repeats itself, and years ago, the walls of Jericho came tumbling down.
Very well put, legend, and this opponent for Jericho, the full-arm dragon twist, and keeps Jericho now at bay momentarily. Well, Jericho continues to top himself each and every week.
Loves to revise history, doesn't he?
Well, you're not kidding me. We continue to top ourselves each and every week. Big sexy Kevin Nash later on against Lex Luger in this program. And we are going to have, this is going to be a first later on here tonight, fam. Great move. Look at this.
He pulled him on top.
Of course he did. and he kicks out. Not only a disgrace to WCW, this is a disgrace to our industry is what this is.
Making a mockery.
To even have this man in the ring is what... But in what's going to be a first later on tonight, the Wolfpack on their side, Conan, will face a member of Hogan's side of the New World Order, Brian Adams, one-on-one. That is a first in the annals of our program, in the annals of the New World Order, and then they all split right down the middle.
Well, you know, what we hoped that would not happen to WCW a couple years ago is now happening to the New World Order. They are all fighting amongst themselves, and that's what we want to see. Let them beat themselves to a pulp. Right here, Jericho's putting on some heavy-duty pressure.
Sidewalk slam into the Lion Tamer, and Chris Jericho gets the win over this opponent who I refuse to name.
Well, it was obvious this young man was in on the ploy from the start.
Sure he was.
But now even Jericho abuses him and wins with the Lion Tamer.
Chris Jericho is your winner. Wild tag team action.